United Nations Watch, por favor.
Mi nombre es Iris Pérez.
Iris Pérez Aguilera, I'm a human rights defender in Cuba. I lead the Rosa Parks Women's Movement for Civil Rights. Paragraph 56 of the stakeholder summary cites to our submission on the Cuban government's growing use of violence against women, human rights defenders, along with arbitrary arrests and death threats. It's important to highlight that on page 22 of today's report, recommendations by the Netherlands, Norway, Poland, Germany and Hungary address these gross abuses. Mr. President, it is in this regard that I've come to bear witness. I have been the victim of aggressions on the part of the Cuban authorities, especially by the agents Juniel Monteagudo Reina and Eric Aquino Llera. They've beat me into unconsciousness on the pavement, as took place most recently this past March 7 in Santa Clara. The hits to the head, neck and back have caused me serious health problems that I have not been able to recover from. In addition to beating me, they have threatened me with death on various occasions. These occasions have told me that they were going to rape me and have showed me their genitals during arbitrary arrests. Because I'm a black woman, the cruelty has been worse because the government that exists in Cuba is racist. At this moment, Sonia Garro Alfonso remains in prison and has been there since March 2012 without trial. In October 2011, Laura Poyan, leaders of the Ladies in White, died under suspicious conditions while under the custody of the political police in Havana. Daisy Talavera Ortiz, an activist in Matanza, died run over by the car in January the same year. The women human rights defenders in Cuba have been suffering break-ins to their houses, assaults of their children, arbitrariness of the governments for the last 54 years. Soon I will return to Cuba. I ask the United Nations for protection for my life and the lives of thousands of human rights activists in Cuba today. The authorities in Havana should respond. Why do they murder and systematically violate the rights of the citizens in Cuba? Thank you very much.
Voy a leer una aclaración.
I need to read a clarification for the language to be used for the respect of dignity in this room.
I want everyone to adhere to language that is commensurate with the dignity inherent to the discussion on human rights issues. I count on your support in ensuring that a sense of respect permeates our discussion. Everyone has a right to express his or her views, but this should remain within the accepted framework. Tolerance and respect should be the key words of the work of this council. With this in mind, I give the floor to the next speaker.
This exercise cannot be hijacked to be used by some to launch attacks and lies and fabrications and allegations about those by mercenaries who are paid by foreign powers, and to make recommendations that run counter to the inalienable principles such as the sovereignty of states or the right to self-determination.